finally, pop stars come and pop stars go, and sometimes it's blink and you miss them. But occasionally, a musician appears whose dedication to excellence allows him to span the generations. I hope I'm not making him sound too old, because I'm not very much younger myself. I was a fan. I am a fan of Paul McCartney. You can't hear him sing yet, because I just want to talk to him just for a couple of minutes. Right. It's a new band. This is the new band. Hello, band. Is this the band that's going on a big tour?
Yes, this is the same band, unless we sack them all. In the meantime,
but you're
this
not
is very
you're
possible. No, just kidding.
And when are you going on this tour?
In September.
Of the world?
September of the world, yes. Oh, we have
you
a
promised,
laugh on
you
this
promised
show, don't
not
I?
To
no,
send
I'm just kidding.
You promised. Listen, it can't be for the money, it can't be for the fame, it must be because you adore music.
It is, yes, I do like doing it.
Just a little?
Yeah, well, I do, I love it. It keeps me off the streets.
And some new songs you've been writing with Elvis Costello.
Yes, that's right. On the new album, which is called Flowers in the Dirt, plug. And
why not?
There's about four of them with Elvis.
How do you write the songs with Elvis? What do you actually do?
A pencil. You get a little pencil. And you...
I knew it was going to be like this.
No,
I could tell.
Come on, you sit down.
With your guitar.
We sat down with two acoustic guitars, kind of across from each other, and. Just started making up things, and then I'd sort of say, well, I don't like that, or he'd say he didn't like that. We'd just edit each other, and he's good at writing songs, and, you know, so we kind of got on like two craftsmen kind of thing. It was good fun.
I heard you say somewhere that it was the nearest you'd come to writing with John Lennon, that it's a similar kind of partnership.
Yeah, he reminded me of John a little bit. Just, I think mainly, main thing is like the idea that he's got a kind of strong exterior and a kind of warm interior, which sort of John had. But he takes no messing around and stuff, you know, but it were grand.
So you come along with a kind of nice line and he puts in the acid wit.
Well, I think so, yeah. It was a bit like that, you know, obviously not really like John, but probably the most I've worked like John than with anybody else in the world.
All right, and we're settled for that. It has to be said, and they'll find out in a minute, but there's a distinct 60s Beatlish sound about it, huh?
But not the whole album, but just some of the tracks. Yeah, I think Elvis kind of led me a little bit towards that, because he's a fan of the kind of 60s stuff, you know. Mm.
So you're off on tour, which must be, I don't understand why you want to do it. I mean, we're talking about hell on earth, walking to the Arctic, but I mean, it must be hell. Packing, unpacking for 12 months.
It is hell, Sue. It's not easy at the top. It's a tough life. In fact, I think we ought to cancel the tour right here. No.
Don't do that. I shall go away, because you obviously want to play. You don't want to talk to me at all, do you?
Can
like
we?
To
no, I
do. I'm going away while you play. What I've been calling all afternoon, Pieces of Eight.
Pieces of Eight, which, as bad as me.
I know, because of the parrot and all that. It's called Figure of Eight.
Figure of Eight, yeah.
And then after that, we're going to have the latest single, which is My Brave Face.
My Brave Face.
Did I get that right?
Yes, that's right.
Right, we've got some dancers, especially for you. Shall we have the dancers on stage? And shall I leave you to...
Got me down. Dog.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, and welcome to Cracker Jack. Cracker Jack. We'd like to do a song off a new album, what is called My Brave Face. One, two, three, four.
Promotions. One is for James Payne's florist of Hastings, who provided tonight's lovely floral creations. They'll be exhibiting at the Chelsea Flower Show next week. This one, courtesy of Charlton Heston, of course. The other shameless promotion is for myself. I'll be back next week when my guests will include Thora Heard, Julie Walters, Cliff Richard, and Jason Donovan. Don't miss a moment of it. I'm being sent up again.